Alrighty, we're going to talk about wiring a multi-wire branch circuit. We have two circuits that are going to be sharing the same neutral, and there's different ways to wire it. Here in the country I was born in, we use 14 American wire gauge on 15 amps, 12 American wire gauge on 20 amps. Black is live, white is neutral, the bare of the green is the ground. Red and blue are also live colors, however, you may find white live a switch loop or 220-240 volt circuit where the appliance does not require a neutral. So what we have here is coming into our from the breaker box. This is a sub panel. So you keep the neutral and the ground separate, but in a main panel, you can put the neutral and the ground together on the same bus bar. So this is our white, which is neutral, our red, which is alive, our black, which is alive, our bare wire, which is our ground wire. Okay, so first we will wire our wires into the breaker box. We'll take our ground wire, bring it over to the bottom of the panel here, flatten it out, bring it up. And we'll bend it over so it goes straight into our ground bar, which is bonded to the box. Make sure the wire comes through the hole all the way. Okay, so next we'll bring our white wire we'll go to the back of the box, come over, make our wire nice and straight. Light on the neutral bar. Make sure the copper is coming through. We'll get our wire going nice and straight here. Okay, now when you put your two circuit breakers in, you have to make sure they're on opposite legs of the 240 so you don't overload your neutral. If you're using 14 gauge wire, you'll use a 15 amp breaker, and if you're using number 12, you can use a 20 amp breaker. So we'll bring our wire down to our corner like this, bring it up, bring it over, and then we will strip it to go into our circuit breaker. Strip with the hole that matches the wire gauge. Tighten our screws up. There's one. Okay, now we'll bring our black wire, which is our second circuit, bring it over to the corner, bend it in, bend it over where the breaker is. So that is how you dress your wires inside the breaker box. So now we'll come to our first outlet. So here in the country I was born in, we usually use wire nuts to connect our wires together. We do have the way goes. We'll strip our wires like they're. Get all our insulation even at the top and our copper even at the end here. So they're not even, so we're going to cut them so they're even with the shortest one. Hold them so they stay even, put our wire nut on. Now look down inside, make sure our copper is all. Our insulation is all down into the wire nut, and the insulation is down into this portion of the raised part of the wire nut here. So we have our white. We get our browns. Even at the end here like that, take your wire nut. Make sure you all stay even as you tighten the wire nut. And I hold the tail so everything stays tight. There's our ground wires. Put our reds together. Make sure all our insulation is even at the bottom and our copper is even at the top, which it is. Take our wire nut. There's our nuts. Now we'll get our wax. Wires are stripped to the same length. We're going to get our copper even at the top. And this one up just a bit. Copper all even at the top, and the insulation all even at the bottom. Like that. Make sure you're going perfectly even. Put the wire nut on there. Okay, so we have our two circuits and our shared neutral and our ground wire. So we'll hook up our first outlet. The live wire goes on the brass screw, which is the narrow slot. The white wire goes on the silver screw, which is the wider slot. And the ground wire goes on the green screw. And since we have two circuits coming into this outlet, we have to break our little tab off. See this little tab here between the two halves of the outlet? We have to take our needle nose pliers, hold it like that, and we'll just rock it back and forth, and you'll see how it broke off of the outlet. You'll watch it drop. Thank you. Jason, okay. Those up. We'll take about an inch of insulation off of each wire here. So we can put our ground wire up first. The ground will go on our green screw right here. One screw we're not using, so it's out of the way and doesn't touch something we don't want to touch. And we'll put our white on our silver colored screw. Then put our wire around the screw the direction our screw turns, close the direction our screw turns. We'll put red on the top. It doesn't matter if you put the red on the top or the black on the top. Just for cosmetic reasons, you want to keep them. If you have many outlets, you want to put all of them, split them all. You put the red on the top or the black on the bottom or the black on the top and the red on the bottom. Just keep it the same on all of them for cosmetic reasons. And so the live wire. You want to make sure you don't get your insulation under the screw head. Okay, so there's our first outlet. Now over here, we're going to put a light switch in. No damage to our wire stripping it. Alrighty, so. Thank you. So we'll strip our white wires. Make sure the wires are the same length on the ends here. All the copper's even on the end here, and our copper's even at the end, and our insulation's even at the bottom. So make sure they're even. Put our wire nut on, make sure. Okay, so there's our white wires together. We're going to put our outlet on the red and our light on the black. What we can do is take get our ground wires together, and also we have to go to each device with our ground. So we get our off of our ground wires even here, like this. Gotta make sure they're all even. Put our wire nut on. So now we can hook our devices up. So we're going to put our switch and light on the black. Sure, why don't you close your loop around the screw so it's under the screw head all the way around? And now we'll hook our wires on the switch. You always go to direction the screw turns. It's single pull, it doesn't matter which one goes on the top or the bottom. Here in the country I was born in, up is on, down is off. Now if you put your single pole switch in upside down, it will say no rather than on. Your loop reflection screw turns. If you is nice and snug there, so she's not caught under our screw gun. And now we can look on the outlet. We leave the link on this one because it's on one circuit. The top and the bottom half are on the same circuit. Then you close the screws you're not using, so they're on the way to that way. Okay, so I'll go get my multimeter and I'll show you something. Alrighty, this is our multimeter. We will put it on 600 volts. We'll turn our circuit breakers on. Now between the red and the black, we have 242 volts. So we have 240 between the red and the black. Now between the red and the white, and over here, between the black and the neutral, we have 121.2 volts. Between the red and the ground, we have 121.2 also. So at the between the red and the black on our outlet, we have 240. Between the red, flip this around. Between the red and the white, we have 120. Between the black and the white, we have 120. So that is how to wire a multi-wire RAM circuit different ways. There you can get a close up. Here's the light on one circuit, the outlet on the other circuit. A little tab broken out between the red and the black, white and the neutral, and the bare ground layer. Alrighty, thanks for watching. That is how to wire a multi-wire branch circuit here in the country I was born in. With a multi-wire branch circuit is two circuits sharing one neutral, and they are on opposite legs of the 240. Peace. Thanks for watching.